Alright, this is my 2001 Isuzu Rodeo. In another video I showed cleaning the EGR valve right there. In this video I'm going to take the EGR valve off and clean the tube between the EGR and the throttle body. I didn't do that last time, but I think I'm going to go ahead and clean that out today. So I will try to show each step along the way. First thing first, I need to remove this cover on the engine, which just is essentially held on there with a couple of little posts that slide into the back side of the cover. We'll get that off. And next I'm going to need to disconnect the boot coming off the air intake. I'll have to remove the clip here and slide all this stuff apart. Looks like there's a coolant line or some sort of breather tube coming off of it here. I'll have to remove that. Remove this clamp here to get to the throttle body. And then I'll have to take the throttle body off. So anyway, I'm going to get started and show what it looks like when I get everything removed. Alright, so I've basically already done all the work. It was kind of hard to film as I did it just because I didn't have any help to hold the camera. So anyway, I figured I'd sort of fall back now and show how everything came apart. It actually ended up being even easier than I thought. And you know, I'm not an expert by any means, so I think anybody could handle this project. But anyway, I started with taking the clips off the air box, the air intake box, where the filter is housed. I broke that loose, and there's an electrical connection right here, which I'm guessing is the mass airflow sensor. So you disconnect that. There's another electrical connection here that snaps loose. Then I loosened the ring clamp that connects the air intake boot to the throttle body. Then disconnected this breather hose here. Just had to be real careful not to split the hose as I pulled it off. So then you can remove this whole assembly out and set that off to the side. Then you can see the throttle body here. It's connected with four bolts. One here, one here. I've already got it loose. I'll pull it out and show you. There's two more on the bottom side, here and here. There's also, and this was the tricky part, there's also a coolant line connection here and here. And this was definitely the trickiest part. No big deal, but you can see here's one coolant line for the left side. Here's the other one for the right side. And they're just hard to get to. They've got small hose clamps on them. What I ended up doing was, you know, loosen the hose clamp and get it down out of the way, and sort of gently took a flathead screwdriver and just pried a little bit to try to loosen it from around the tubing connector here, and then just sort of took a pair of channel locks or vice grips and gently grabbed the hose with one hand and the pliers and just pulled, and I was able to pull the throttle body apart from one side, and then it made it easier to get the other side loose. I did the same thing on the other side. Of course, there's coolant in these lines, so try to keep them aimed up when you pull them loose. And then I happened to have a couple of bolts that were basically the same diameter, so I just sort of shoved them down in the line and tightened the hose clamp on both sides to keep all the coolant from draining out while I was working on it. So now the throttle body was loose at that point, and of course it was real dirty, so I just used some throttle body cleaner. Let me show you what I used. It's a Valvoline carbon throttle body cleaner. Used that and a little soft bristle brush to sort of clean out all the deposits. Got it nice and clean. Then I took the old gasket off because it pretty much disintegrated when I pulled the throttle body off, and cleaned this surface here where the gasket seats. I took a flat razor knife. See if I have it here somewhere. Yeah. Took a blade just like that and basically just gently scraped the surface to get the rest of the residue off, and then wiped it down clean. then, once I had that off,
I don't know if you show up in this video, but there is a small tube up inside here, inside the air intake, right in there with my fingers pointed. You can't see it on the camera, I don't think, but that is the tube that comes from the EGR valve, and I think that is what was clogged up with all of the carbon deposits, which was contributing to the problem I was having before. I cleaned the EGR, but wanted to clean this tube as well. I'd read that that, you know, certainly helps performance of the engine, so I cleaned that using a pretty simple process, which I will show you next.
Okay, so here's the process I used to clean the tube coming from the EGR valve. Like I said, it's really simple. One step I forgot to mention in taking everything apart. There's another electrical connection here that connects to the, there's like a servo motor on the top of the throttle body here that actually controls the throttle plate. Apparently there's no throttle cable coming from the gas pedal. It's actually electronically controlled, so I think this connection here will basically turn the motor on the side of the throttle body, which adjusts the throttle body plate, the intake plate that allows more air into the engine. So you have to disconnect this right here, it just snaps loose. So anyway, back to my cleaning procedure. I had read in a couple places that seafoam deep creep is really good to sort of break all the deposits loose and lubricate everything. So I started with this, and what I did was I had a little piece of fuel line laying around, and it was the perfect diameter to insert the spray tube from the body, the bottle, into the inside of the fuel line. Then I had another one, another spray tube laying around that I was able to insert in the other end. And then what I did was just basically stuck it right inside the tube, inside the intake that leads from the EGR, and then just sprayed some deep creep up in there several times, let it soak for a minute, and then, you know, took everything apart. Then I took a took my air compressor with a just a spray tip. It's got a flexible rubber tip, and went up here where the EGR sits. Of course, I've already taken the EGR loose and inserted it in the intake port that leads to the intake. And once you blow some compressed air in there, it'll sort of clear out that tube. Now, it's going to shoot stuff everywhere if you're not careful. So what I did was stuffed paper towels all up in the opening here to sort of catch all the debris that came out. And then just use the air hose up here. Of course, there's nothing in there now, so I'm going to go ahead and spray it. It won't shoot out too much junk, but you can hear it coming through. So I feel like I got it pretty clean. Of course, now I'm ready to put everything back together. You want to make sure that the mounting surface for the gasket is nice and clean. I've already already purchased a new gasket before I started, so I'm ready to put everything back together now, and I will show you what it looks like when it's all back together, and we'll start the engine and see how it does. All right, so I'm sort of halfway back together here. Figured I'd show what it looks like with the throttle body reconnected. You can see the four bolts that hold it in place, two on the top, two on the bottom, and you can see down here, this is where the coolant hose connects on the left side, and on the right side, that's the hose connector that holds it on. When I put it back together, I put the right side on first, just because it was behind this electrical connection here, it was harder to get to, and I just smeared a little bit of Vaseline on the outside of the tube. On the throttle body, and that made it pretty easy to slide the hose back on. So I connected those first, then I got the new gasket and put it on the back of the throttle body and slipped the top two bolts through first to line up the holes and put them through the gasket, sort of got those started, then did the bottom two, and then tightened everything up carefully. I also used NICs on the bolts, so if I ever have to do this again, hopefully the bolts will come out pretty easily. And then I also used dielectric grease on the electrical connection. And then, of course, I also put the EGR back on. There's a bolt on the left side and a bolt on the right down here, which you can't see, and put that electrical connection back together. Used dielectric grease there as well. So, anyway, that's how it looks now. I'm going to finish putting the air intake boot and air box back on, and we'll be finished. All right, so everything's put back together. Air box is clamped back down. The airflow sensor connection is made back up. This hose here is connected again. Electrical connection here is made. Cover's back on. Should be good to go. I'm just gonna try to start it up now and see how it does. There we go. The engine's revving a little bit, I think, because there's probably some throttle cleaner left in the intake, but should be good to go. Once it sort of burns all that residue off, I think we'll be back in business. So there we go. Thanks a lot for watching.